Unit 6, Animals, written by Walt Whitman. Walt Whitman, an American poet, essayist, and journalist. Most influential poets in early American poetry, called the father of free verse. Explanation of first stanza. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. I stand and look at them long and long. In this stanza, the poet expresses his desire to turn away from human beings and live with animals because he feels that animals are calm, quiet, and self-contented. He prefers to live among them and gazes at them for a long time. Now the second stanza. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Not one is dissatisfied, not one is demented with mania of owning things. The animals, according to the poet, are satisfied about their lot and never crave for anything. They do not have sleepless nights as they don't commit any crimes or sins. As they have clear conscience, they do not pray to God for forgiveness. The animals are always contented and do not hanker after materialistic possessions like human beings. So the third stanza, not one kneels to another, nor to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. So they show their relations to me and I accept them. They bring me tokens of myself, they evince them plainly in their possession. The poet wants to live with animals because they enjoy equality and nobody has to bend before others. They have sense of equality and none is burdened with sorrow. The qualities found in animals are once human qualities. The last stanza. I wonder where they get those tokens. Did I pass that way huge times ago and negligently drop them? The poet believes that in good old times, the human beings had the virtues of modesty, contentment, selflessness, etc., which they have lost with the passage of time. Now, these qualities are found among animals. Animals have picked up these qualities from human beings when they abandoned them. The literary devices used in this poem, alliteration, repetition, anaphora, metaphor, and pun. Pun, I stand and look at them long and long. Here the word long has different meanings to create humor. One meaning is looking at the animals for a long time. The second meaning is longs to be one of them. The rhyme scheme in this poem, it is of free verse. So the message is, human beings should imbibe the virtues which they have lost in the process of civilization. They should be calm and contented with what they have. They should shed their false sense of respectability and refrain from practicing any discrimination in the name of God and religion. They must learn to stay away from the mania of owning things. Thank you.